Hello everyone, this is Majid Hussain, and I'm here to present my final year presentation on the topic DSP-based power pole board design for DC to DC converters. So this project has been supervised by Dr. Fahim Ahmed Chacher, and co-supervisor is Engineer Manur Mughal, and along with me, my group mate is Abdul Muqtadir. So here is the flow of our presentation, starting from introduction, a literature review, problem statement, proposed solution, AMS, methodology, result, and finally the conclusion. So here is the introduction. As you all know, that DC to DC converters are basically electronic devices that are used to change DC voltage level from one to another. It works similarly like a transformer does. However, there are differences between them. Like converters have high efficiency, and they used switch mode power conversion technique to work efficiently. Because of the switching conversion, the power is transferred, power is converged very efficiently, and voltage level are changed according to the need. Power electronics is now considered as emerging technologies, and DC to DC converters have wide range nowadays. They have applications ranging from cellular phones, laptop, to electrical vehicles nowadays. Also, they are highly used in grid station as well as power stations in electrical system. So it is crucial for the power electronics students to study and perform them in hardware, to analyze and understand the working of converters like buck boost and buck boost. Though we have the methods or option to use for studying and analyzing these converters or designing them on a board, but there are separate modules for each converter. So our scheme proposes in a board that will host multiple converters on that single board. Also, the board is interfaced with microcontroller or a DSP to analyze its impact of digital control mechanism. Moving ahead. So here is the literature review that we have done so far. Though we have studied a lot of literature in different articles, but some of the prominent and well-known research papers have been present here, and the useful points have been shown. The first chapter, first research paper is a market analysis of DC to DC converters and its applications. In this research paper, the writer has put focus on the market analysis and its growing market in computer as well as communication sector. And about the applications of converters that can be used with digital control to increase the life of power supplies. The second research paper is the restructuring of first courses in power electronics. This paper has been written by Ned Mohan, which is basically about the academic side of these converters and power electronic courses, in which students were lacking interest and they were canceling and dropping out these courses from the curriculum, and they were not studying these courses. It was because of the lack of students' interest in these courses. So Ned Mohan had suggested in this paper that by integrating these converters with digital control, the interest of a student can be developed, and by performing them in hardware, students will get interested and can easily understand these concepts and will take these courses. So the last and the third article that is presented here is a building block in which the writer has presented data that I will quote here, which is, it is a dangerous trend in many universities to move from hardware to purely software-based laboratories. As here and in many other universities, it is very common to perform these converters only on simulations. We just simulate them and understand the concept that is only simulation based. However, it is very important for a student to perform these in practical and understand their use and to test them in hardware. So here the focus has been on this side in this research paper. So what basically is the problem here? The problem is very simple. We don't have lab setup for these students to perform these converters, topologies on a board. Though there are some trainers or kits available in the labs to study these converters, but they are huge, complex, and their cost is very high because of having other components is required by the trainer. The students cannot comprehend the concept or design the circuit as it is required. So these additional components increase the cost as well as design complexity. And because of the limited lab timing, all the students cannot easily perform these converters or separately perform these converters or design these converters. So what is the solution to this problem? The solution is very clear. It is to design a board that can host multiple converter topologies on a single board. The board is known as power pole board, and it is an easy and very effective option to design a board that can host multiple converter topologies. It will be a PCB-based board that can be called as power pole board. Its cost is much less as compared to other available options in the market. So what are the aims and objectives of the project? The first objective is to design a simplified power pole board that will host multiple converter topologies on a single board. After that, designing a PCB board, for a compact design to print this board on it. The third one is to interface that board with a DC to DC converters for its reconfiguration. And finally, the saving of cost. So here is the design that we have made using Eagle Autodesk software. The bigger picture shows the main power pole board design having all the sections here. This is the board design that has been designed in Eagle software, containing the PWM circuitry, gate driver circuitry, input side, as well as output side. These two similar boards, which are the magnetic board for buck and boost converter, and the lower board is for the buck boost converter topologies. So this is the board file of the SAM schematic design that I just showed you. So this is the final design to be printed. The PCB will look like, and the connection will be same like it is shown here. These are the designs of the data boards, and this is the parent board, the power pole board, and these two are the data boards for buck boost and for buck boost converter. So here is an interesting slide which shows the features of our board. The first and foremost is multiple topologies can be designed on a single board. The power rating is approximately 20 watt. Input of 3 to 12 volt can be used, like 5 volt, 3 volt, 12 volts. External generated PWM circuit, internally generated PWM circuit, isolated gate driver circuitry, duty cycle control, and so on. These are all of the features that this board will have that a student can use to perform and analyze the concept of power electronics by using different voltage levels and full duty cycle control, different topologies, PWM control. So these are the features of our board. Here is the final design that we have achieved after PCB and soldering, the finalized design, the product we have got. This is the input side of breadboard. These are the output sides. These are two MOSFETs used for the gate driver circuitry. These two are the daughter boards. One in, the upper one is used for buck and boost converter. The lower one is used for buck boost only.
Assalamu alaikum. So as my friend told you about the final project, this is a final project. From here, we will move to digital control mechanism. And I will tell you. So digital control mechanism, first of all, in digital control mechanism, we have used AVR microcontroller 8Mega328P. That is the same microcontroller that is also used in our Arduino. Then we have generated a PWM. Then we have used Arduino IDE to generate that frequency. It was an open source code used from Arduino.cc to generate a PWM of 48 kilohertz. Voltage calibration was done through potentiometer. Now, what is voltage calibration? Voltage calibration means if we have a 10 volt output, 10 volt input, and we have to give it to our microcontroller to sense the voltage and based on that voltage to generate a PWM. But our microcontroller can only handle up to 5 volts. So we use a potentiometer to calibrate it in a sense that 1 volt is equal to 2 volt. So through this, then we have observed our results. So this is the flow diagram of digital control mechanism, where at pin number 23, we have sent the voltage through potentiometer. And based on that analog voltage sensing, we have calibrated our voltage. And then we have generated the PWM based on that sensed voltage. And through pin number 5, which is a PWM pin, we have taken the output and interfaced it with our microcontroller. Next. So this is during testing what we have done, that through this potentiometer, we are sensing our voltage. And through this microcontroller, we are generating a frequency of 48 kilohertz and interfacing that same frequency over here at the gate driver circuitry. So these are some basic features. But before that, I would like to tell you about our digital control mechanism, that there are two approaches for that. The first one is an open loop. The second one is a closed loop. In an open loop fashion, we just generate digital PWM and send it to our our converter. While on the other hand, in a closed loop fashion, we generate PWM, but that is based on the voltage we sense from the output of the converter in a closed loop fashion. So these are basic features. So for our buck converter, we have input voltage as 12 volt, frequency 48 kilohertz, and load resistance is 110 ohm, and duty cycle control is 10 to 80%. For our boost converter, we have 3 volt input, 48 kilohertz frequency, 70 ohm resistance, and we have duty cycle of 10 to 80%. So for buck boost converter, we have 5 volt input, 48 kilohertz, 80 ohm frequency, and 10 to 80% duty cycle. Here are the results with our internal PWM circuitry. For buck converter, we have input supply as 12 volt. Then this is the result at 20% duty cycle. So 20% result, this is our, the blue line is our PWM, generated PWM internal, and this is our DC cycle, DC input or output. So you can say that, see that there is 2.74 and of 20% of 12 volt is around 2.5. So it is nearly 2%, a calibration precise of 0.2%. Let's get back to here in our buck converter. Here's again, we have a 50% duty cycle. We have exactly 6.1 volt. And this is our PWM, this is our DC cycle, DC output. Thank you. So let's talk about boost converter. For boost converter, this is our PWM, the green one, and the blue one is our output. It is at 20% that it is 3.2. While it, in this picture on the right hand side, and boost converter, we have 30% duty cycle, and 30% duty cycle, this is 3.9, which is exactly equal to 4. These are the results for our buck boost converter through internal PWM. Here's the input supply for 5, input supply is 5 volt, and the results are there. Here's PWM, and then we have a DC cycle, DC output at 20% duty cycle. And for buck boost converter, at 40%, we have this blue line is output, it is 1.6, and we have PWM. Let's move ahead. So these are all hardware results. Here's the buck converter result boost converter results and buck boost converter results against the duty cycle for internal PWM. Now with digital control mechanism, when we have generated digital PWM and we have interfaced that with our converter, the results are here. For buck converter at 20%, you can see it's the green that is the output and the blue one is the PWM. So here you can see 2.5 volt. That's exactly what I said again, that it was 2.5 and here is 2.522, means 0.22 precise. So that's a good one. And on the other hand, we have for 60% duty cycle, here's a PWM, and with the PWM, here's our output that is again 7.1. Exactly, it should be 7.2, means a 0.1 precision. So that's great. Okay. With this, we have our boost converter results with our digital control mechanism. So here are, you can say, see that 10%. This blue one is the, our PWM, the green one is our DC output. At 10%, it's again around 3.3 volt. And for 50%, it's 4.5. This is the green one is the output. Again, blue one is the PWM. So here's a buck boost converter results for 40 and 50%. At 40%, this blue one is our output. Again, here is, it is also our output. And the green one is our PWM. So it is 2.2 at 40% for voltage of 5. And for here for 50%, it's 1.9. Okay. So let's see our hardware results. These are our hardware results where these are duty cycle. And this, these are the results of buck converter, boost converter, and buck boost converter with our digital control mechanism against the duty cycle. Okay, so let's conclude. In conclusion, this project, the PowerPole board has been designed to handle four experiments. It is, number one is buck converter experiment, boost converter experiment, buck boost converter experiment, and power MOSFET switching characteristics experiment. The scope of the project can be further extended by implementing flyback and forward converter with the help of flyback coupled inductor. Okay, the design has been interfaced with the microcontroller in an open loop fashion. With that, we have achieved means 0 to 100% a precise control. But in future, the board can be interfaced with the microcontroller in a closed loop fashion to analyze the effects. From literature, it has been observed that with that, the efficiency will improve. These are our references, few of our references that we have done after our literature review. So here we go with our final presentation. And this is our final